Good morning and welcome to our service for today. And today our reading comes from Matthew chapter 11, verses 16 to 19, and then 25 to the end. But to what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. At that time, Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
In the reading from the Gospel, Jesus appears to be irritated by the people and notices how fickle they can be. He has been praising John the Baptist, yet he is all too aware of the things people have been saying about John, criticising him because of the way he ruled his life, with his strict observance of fasting and abstinence. Some people found him too narrow in his outlook. His way of life was not attractive and certainly not one the majority of people felt they could follow. Some even suggested he was possessed. In contrast, Jesus enjoyed being in the midst of people. He liked to socialise, to eat and drink. Did this make him popular? Well, certainly to some, but to others, he too was criticised, called a glutton and drunkard. He moved in circles that were not considered the best. Most Jews would have stayed away, well away from them. As a friend to tax collectors and sinners, he appeared to make no distinction, although some would argue that he favoured the social outcasts. The kingdom of God was and is for all people that wish to follow him. So it seems Jesus learned early on in his ministry that it's impossible to please all of the people all of the time. He likens the people's behaviour to that of a children's game. Further on in this reading, we find Jesus thanking his Father that he reveals himself to those who are humble and childlike in their approach to him, and that he hides from the wise and the intelligent. But like many other statements, that is a generalisation. We all know that wise and intelligent people, are just as welcome in the kingdom as those who are not. But the point Jesus is making is that we all need to be like children. Jesus is not saying we should deny the importance of thought, but rather that we need to acknowledge our inability to discover God on our own. God reveals himself in Christ to those who are willing to hear and listen. And it's important to remember that it is God who initiates and we who respond, not the other way around. It is not something we are doing for God, but rather what God is doing for us. So to be like children. So let's first differentiate between what it means to be childish and childlike. To be childish in our belief surely means we haven't faced the realities of life. Inwardly, we are still infants. Our faith hasn't developed, or perhaps it's stunted. Maybe because of circumstances in our lives. The childish tend to have closed minds and can only see things in their way. Therefore, they may miss out on what God is saying to them, because God rarely speaks to us in the way we expect, and the childish are too afraid or too stubborn to consider any other way. For the childlike in faith, God is a constant source of joy and delight. They somehow have managed to break away from that which is familiar and well known. They feel that they are able to go off and explore, investigate and learn more about God. They find that exciting and challenging, and they're also able to allow others to explore as well, in whichever way they wish, and to be willing to discuss and to listen to other opinions. Childlike tend to have an open mind and therefore are ready to receive whatever comes their way. So it is the childlike who, upon hearing God's word, are more likely to respond because they are open to new ideas and influence. And this has nothing to do with intelligence or brain power. When Jesus said, "Truly, I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it," he was talking about being childlike rather than childish. He was talking about the qualities of acceptance and joy, and the ability to find delight in the simplest things. If there is anything good that can come out of the last few months, I believe one of them is that we have all noticed and felt close to God in his creation and have appreciated it in a way that perhaps we had almost forgotten in the usual busyness of life. Jesus wants us to have an open mind and be prepared to explore in order to discover the truth. And we need to allow ourselves and others to rejoice in our uniqueness without the need to expect to fulfill expectations that we or others have of us. And then finally, Jesus assures us that he will take our burdens from us. "Come to me, all who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." When we recognize we need his help, when we are aware that we are spiritually weak, be assured, Jesus will walk along beside us through our troubles and trust that he will lighten our load. We still have to sort out our problems and we still need to take responsibility for our actions. But with Jesus guiding us, we will come to know how and what to do. And as we live a life putting our trust in him, we will find it brings us peace, joy and fulfillment. During the week, I came across a song by a young man called Jamie Kimmett, the title of which is Burdens, which we're going to listen to now.
When the deepest sorrow weighs on your heart, when there's a promise he will make your burdens light.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." And so in our prayers today, let us bring to Jesus our burdens and seek his rest and his peace. We thank you, Lord, that you are more ready to hear than often we are to pray, and willing to give us more than we desire or deserve. And so we come to you today for rest, for renewal, for strength to do what you would have us to do. In our prayers today, we're going to use a response after a moment of silence. And so when I say, "Lord, we come to you," you might like to respond with, "Renew us and give us peace." Lord, we come to you. Renew us and give us peace. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the church throughout the world. We remember today all who are weary in their service, especially as a result of the additional challenges presented by coronavirus. We pray for church leaders and ministers who are working in difficult areas and with little support. And we ask for your blessing upon all those who are seeking to share the burdens of those with great responsibilities. We pray for all who are carers and who are giving support to others. Lord, we come to you. Renew us and give us peace. As we rejoice in the gift of life, we remember the world weary, the struggling and the anxious. We pray for all who are burdened with troubles or guilt. We ask your blessing upon all who are overworked or oppressed, and those who are fearful for the future. We pray for those who have lost the joy of living, and all who struggle to relax and find rest. Lord, we come to you. Renew us and give us peace. We give thanks for our friends and our loved ones, for those who share our joys and our sorrows. We pray for all those who have been a support and comfort to us. And we also pray for families where there is tension and stress, and remember all who feel lonely and without help. Lord, we come to you. Renew us and give us peace. We pray today for all those who are unwell or are finding life difficult. We pray for all who seek to be a help and a support. And we ask your blessing upon all who have found their rest in you. We pray for all those who are struggling with grief following the death of someone they have loved. May each of these find rest and renewal in you. Lord, we come to you. Renew us and give us peace. And we gather all of our prayers, spoken and unspoken, together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Well, we are definitely recording. It's exciting.
I can see it, and today I'm on my best behaviour.
And I'm going to mute you.
Thank you.
I can't mute you. I can't mute anyone.
I tell you what, I'll mute everybody. Right, Marion, you're gone.
I don't know if I trust you with this. You're both gone. Okay, that's nice. Nice and peaceful. Right. I don't know why you're on the screen. It's me speaking. Why are you on speaker view? Am I on the screen? Oh, because it's me. I don't think I can be on the screen when it's me. Okay, right. So I am on your screens. Okay, right. That's nice. Okay. What am I even reading? Matthew. Matthew 11, 16 to 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello, and welcome to our service for today. Our reading comes from Matthew chapter 11. Verses 16 to 19 and verse 25. But to what will I compare this generation? I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Why are you laughing?
You couldn't see us, could you?
No.
No.
You haven't finished the reading.
No, you need to read the rest of it as well.
You said 16 to 19 in verse 25.
25 to the end, I think, isn't it? 25 to...
25 to the end. Oh, there's a good bit for the outtakes.
Oh yeah, my burden is easy. Oh God.
Your burden has just been made more difficult.
Joe?
Yes?
Can I suggest that you stop recording and we'll start again?
Hi.
Your editing is going to be all sorts of funny at this rate of going.
Oh, it's fine. It's fine. We'll just carry on. Let's plow on. Right.
So I'm going to mute us off and then
mute us again. Then.
So read the rest.
It was a simple instruction. Right. Right. Are we okay? Good. We're good. Don't make me laugh. One, two, three, four, five. Hello and welcome to our service for today. Our reading comes from Matthew chapter 11, verses 16 to 19, and then 25 to the end. But to what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. At that time, Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are heavy and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I did it.
Well done.
No. Oh, thanks. Make sure you go to the end this time. So funny.